In the aftermath of the Charleston Church massacre, citizens in South Carolina and beyond are urging the state to remove the Confederate flag that flies over the state capitol. Critics say it's a symbol of hatred. Supporters argue it's one of heritage. The issue even finding its way into the 2016 campaign trail after the party's previous nominee, Mitt Romney, tweeted his support for taking that flag down. Jeb Bush noting that while Florida governor, he moved the flag to a museum. Lindsey Graham, South Carolina's senior senator, saying maybe the flag's location should be revisited given its ties to the Charleston gunman. Still others say the issue is one that needs to be decided by South Carolinians.
The state of South Carolina has dealt with this issue in the past. They've done so in a way that brought people together. The current location was the result of a bipartisan agreement that state came to over 15, 20 years ago. And if in fact they're going to take up that issue now, I'm very confident that they're going to make the right choice for South Carolina in a way that all of their people are comfortable with. They've shown a capacity to be able to do that.
I feel like it's not an issue for a person running for president. Everyone's being baited with this question as if somehow that has anything to do whatsoever with running for president, and my position is it most certainly does not.
I take the position that the federal government really has no role in determining what the states
You're
are going to do.
You're a candidate for president. Do you not have a position on this at all?
I'm not a South Carolinian, and I think this is a decision.
It's beyond South Carolina.
I would say that these are decisions that should be made by people. You know, I don't think the federal government or federal candidates should be making decisions on everything and opining on everything. This is a decision that needs to be made here in South Carolina.
All right, before we get to the deeper question here, because really the real question is, should we really be focusing on a flag or are we skirting more important issues? With me now, Charles Blow, opinion writer for the New York Times, and Tara Settenmeyer, former communications director for Republican Congressman Dana Rohrabacher. Okay, so whenever I hear a politician say, oh, it should be up to the individual states to decide, I look upon that as a punt. What about you, Charles?
Well, I mean, there's a big states' rights strain in the Republican Party, right? That is a big part of the platform, and they default to that very often.
Surely they very have
often.
An opinion.
That would be my take. I mean, you have Sarah here to talk about whether or not that should be the Republican Party's opinion. But that is my opinion, that you should be able to take a stand on anything just to state your opinion. You can say, I believe that it should be in their purview. However, if it were me, I would do this or that, right?
So why don't they say that, Tara?
Yeah, I have to say that I'm disappointed in the Republican candidates who have not just come out and taken a stance on this. I think enough is enough now with the Confederate flag issue. It's pretty clear that in 2015, the Confederate flag should not be flying over anybody's capital, should not be in a state capacity, it should be in a museum. Or, you know, some people can make the argument about, well, it's, you know, over a war memorial. Perhaps, but I don't think it should be in any official state capacity anymore. The history is just too painful. It's clearly obvious that whatever the altruistic value of the Confederate flag had for, you know, soldiers and those who fought and the heritage of the South, that is far outweighed by the history and the more recent history of what that flag represents. So I personally would like to see the Republican candidates take a stance on this. Now, I do agree that it is a states' rights issue. I do agree that that is a valid point. We have a 10th Amendment for a reason. I don't think the president should be dictating by fiat what individual states should do for something like this. But I don't see anything wrong with saying that. And also for like a Marco Rubio to come out and say, and I personally, as an American, look at this and find this symbol reprehensible. And I think it's time for it to be in a museum and not
because,
on state capitol.
Because at some point, is it really that dangerous politically to say that the Confederate flag might represent
unfortunately.
In the GOP, it is, right?
Yeah,
so CNN itself in 2011 issued a poll that said that 40% of Republicans identify more with the Confederacy than with the Union, right? So this is a real issue for their base voters, and for Tea Party voters that percentage was even higher. These are the people who are going to show up and go to those primaries. And so when you look at these politicians, you have to look at the politicians not as principled people necessarily, not that they're unprincipled in general, but the political process is not so principled. So it is about primaries and about getting through those primaries and getting elected. If you see your path to being the nominee as going through the South and South Carolina being one of the very first primaries in the South, mm-hmm. then you may not want to ruffle those feathers. It's not and people like Mitt Romney, who are removed from the process, who are thinking about the party as a whole, are thinking more about, is this a kind of barrier to entry for people who might be able to expand the party? Well, if you're in the primaries and you think your path is through the South, that's not what you're thinking about. You're thinking about don't run. feathers, right. And that is what they're doing.
Well, I want to get into something before we run out of town, because, you know, I talked about at the beginning that we should be talking about real issues, maybe not per se the flag. So I'll pose this to both of you. Last year, a study by the Center for American Progress ranked South Carolina as the 9th poorest state in the nation, with one of the highest rates of child poverty. Median income was just over $23,000 a year, $15,000 a year for African Americans. So should policies and not the flag be a bigger concern?
Of course it should be, and I think that's the point of some of these candidates saying that this is really not a national issue. We should be talking about things like what's plaguing South Carolina, the statistics you just brought up.
They're
that's
not
plaguing a
that,
lot.
Though.
Not yet, but they're well because they're being asked about questions about like the Confederate
flag. But in
flag.
The wake of someone killing
yeah,
nine
no,
people and having a flag fetish, you're going to be asked those questions.
Right,
you have to be able to respond.
Right, and they should have been more unequivocal on their positions instead of dragging it on, because by not being more unequivocal, right. It is allowing this to go on, and it is distracting from other more important issues. And I think someone who's going to be a leader on this issue will be Senator Tim Scott in South Carolina. I think that'll be, he's an African American, he's a Republican, he understands the history, he's
yeah,
been through it, and I
he
think
he is not expressing his opinion quite yet.
He basically said that after this is all over and the dust settles, we're going to have a conversation
Which
about
I
race, and
fair.
I'm thinking to myself, where have you been, Tim? We've been having this conversation for like 2 years.
Well, so maybe he's working even, on issues of education
than,
and
that,
body cameras
yes,
for police
but
officers.
But also,
issues that
I
are
think
a little bit more
we have to understand
policy-wise for the citizens of
South Carolina's centrality to the Civil War and what that means, right? The first shots of the Civil War are fired at right. Fort Sumter in South Carolina. This flag may go down last. In South Carolina,
and
we have to understand
that.
I think this may be the final act
of the Confederate flag issue, and I'm hoping that the people of South Carolina make the right decision and they get to the compromise back in 2000. You know, they moved it just to on the grounds, and I think that they'll, after something like this, I think that the people of South Carolina will do the right thing.
Tara Settmeyer, Charles Blow, thanks so much. I appreciate it. Still to come in the newsroom, more on the breaking news out of New York. The search closes in on those two escaped killers. Yes, they found